Hello everybody. In the previous video, you saw all the general functions of the main screen. Now, we'll get a little deeper on the action sets in port. On the main screen, you have all your action sets on the left side. There are several different ways to import files into GoProduce. The first way is to click on Import File, and then you can choose the correct file from your folders. Then click on the file and press Open, and you'll see a preview of your file. In the layer section, you'll see the material. If the material isn't yet specified in the file, it will select the default material. You can change the default material by selecting material in the material manager and then press on the default button. To quickly select the material, you can also type the name in the search box. Here in the layer section, you can also change the category, the material, the thickness you want to use, and the camera profile. Here you can choose the method. Select the tool which is available, and if you want, you can change the tool properties. And then your file is ready to output. In another tutorial, we'll discuss how to output a file. You also have other options to import your file, and that's by barcode. You can import by hand scanner or with the built-in camera in the machine. It's important that you first right-click on it. Go to Import Job, then Import Directory, and here you have to show where the files are located. Then click OK. Also, you have to make sure that your default stays on the right material with the right method and tool. So if you click on Import with hand scanner, this is the screen that you will see. And now you have time to scan your barcode. After you scan the barcode, your file will appear on your screen. To import by barcode workflow, you have to right-click again. Click on Import Job to select your import directory. Click OK once you're done. Then when you click on barcode workflow, this is the screen that you will see. Then you can scan the barcode with the camera. The file will be imported, then sent to the cutter automatically. After the job is finished, the machine will automatically search for the next job. Now we'll get a little deeper on the advanced import features. First, I'm gonna replace the cleanup so all the import settings will be together. You can change or rearrange the positions of the action sets however you want. You can also remove action sets you don't need. Be careful when deleting an action set. It is better to back up all your action sets before deleting them. So in the previous part, you saw if you click on an import action set, the actions will be launched. However, you also right-click on one and then a new window will come up. In the first column, you will see the available actions that you can use in your action set. In the second, you'll see all the actions that are used by the chosen action set. If you click on one, you will see the properties of that action. In the first one, Import Job, you will see a few options. The most important one here is, if you open a job in PDF format, you can separate the layers by layer name, by layer color, and even by spot color name. In the close job action, you can set the margin. The close job action will close any object that contains open lines. And then you have search reg marks. This one is also really important. First, you have to say in which layer your registration mark can be found. You can choose all layers, then each layer will be scanned for registration marks. It is, however, preferred to have a specific layer where the registration marks are stored, given the name of that layer. When using Summa's plugin for CorelDRAW or Illustrator, the registration marks are placed in a layer called RegMark. You also have the shape and size. Here it's important that you fill in the correct shape and the correct size of the designed registration mark. Only then GoProduce will find the registration marks. Registration marks are shown as a circle with a cross in the design. If you want, you can also pick some actions from here and drag it to there. For example, the rotate action. So every time you import the job, it will automatically rotate 90 degrees. And if you want to remove it, just click on it and press the delete button on your keyboard. If you click right on import by hand scanner, you will find all the same settings, except for one additional setting. You first have to fill in the directory where the cutting files are located, like that. Then click OK. Now, when the barcode is scanned, the correct file will be opened in GoProduce. Then you have the barcode workflow on roll. Here you can set the operating zone. Here you have to choose on which part of your machine you want to do the cutting. The back part or the whole bed. In the import job action, you also have to fill the file's location. Those two actions are the same like we have seen before. However, with the barcode workflow, the output job action is also added. The barcode workflow also contains the output job action. This will result in the job being automatically sent to the machine. If you want to pause the feeding after each job, then set the pause when feeding to after feeding. Do not change the other settings for this workflow. Also notice that the repeat checkbox is checked. This will result in the action set being repeated indefinitely. So after each job is cut, the next barcode will be scanned. So that was it for this tutorial. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in our next tutorial called Action Sets Output.